This is a John Wall Street Sports Business Brief. I'm Corey Leff. Foot Locker has invested $100 million into GOAT Group, the parent company of secondary footwear marketplaces GOAT and Flight Club, in a move that CEO Richard Johnson says will help the company to stay relevant with today's digital consumer. GOAT boasts of having over 12 million active users on its platform. Foot Locker, on the other hand, will, along with its capital, bring 3,200 stores across 27 countries to the strategic partnership. Despite selling $10 million worth of shoes in 2018, GOAT Group has just two retail locations. It's been estimated that the Foot Locker investment was made at a valuation between $400 and $500 million. From a strategic standpoint, this partnership is about Foot Locker's deep learning of another facet of the athletic shoe business. The company can now begin to really track retail versus resale pricing and compare that data against the quantities that they're able to purchase. The partnership should also serve as a traffic builder for Foot Locker's brick and mortar retail locations, even if the resale inventory that they keep on hand is limited. While most of the industry's growth is e-commerce based, people actually prefer to shop in physical stores because they want to touch and feel the merchandise. With expensive limited edition sneakers, buyers very well may want to see them in person before making the purchase. The GOAT Group investment also gives Locker a chance to diversify into a tangential business that's still growing. But with sales and interest in athletic shoes on the decline, it's worth wondering if the company is late to the party. MPD Group retail analyst Matt Powell agreed, telling me, "It's noteworthy GOAT Group and that Stadium Goods, which took $250 million from Farfetch, were looking to sell. My sense is that the meteoric growth that the secondary markets experienced throughout the first few years has started to temper, and that the early occupants in the space now see it as the right time to cash out. The sneaker resale market may have peaked, but GOAT Group still has plenty of upside. Once a company establishes themselves and has mastered the authentication and handling parts of the process, it really opens up the marketplace business to sell just about anything. We've seen competitor StockX introduce a substantial watch business in addition to their core sneaker business. It's reasonable to assume that GOAT and Flight Club will begin offering a broader range of products. If you're looking for more sports business news, sign up for our free email newsletter at johnwallstreet.com. And you can follow us on Twitter at Howie Longshort. Remember, new episodes of John Wall Street Sports Business Briefs are released Monday and Tuesday mornings at 11 a.m. Eastern Time on the John Wall Street YouTube channel.